statements. You'll have 2 minutes, and we'll start off with you.
Okay. I am running for mayor because our current government has sold us out and has failed the people of Riverside. The elected officials and city government have failed to recognize that we the people are in charge. But we the people are not paying attention. It's time that the citizens have to take their government back or just pay more or less. I want to thank you for this opportunity, for actually just running for mayor. It was, again, a great experience. I humbly ask for your vote. I also want your mother's vote, your sister's vote. I would also like you to go on your Facebook page and invite them all to vote for me, but I need everybody's vote. So I want to thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Well, I'd like to thank Latino Network, NAACP Riverside Group, and the League of Women Voters for your efforts to inform voters on the issues before us at the ballot box this year. And special thanks to the League of Women Voters for honoring the work of Susan B. Anthony, Elizabeth Cade Stanton, and Lucy Stone in securing the right for women to vote. I certainly would not be before you this evening as a mayoral candidate were it not for these pioneering women. But indeed, I am here tonight, and I am a candidate for mayor of Riverside. Women comprise 50% of our population, yet I don't see that reflected in our elected officials on the dais at City Hall. For too long, too few have been invited or encouraged to participate. Our city government should reflect the composition of our community, and I am here to offer you that choice. I bring over 4 years of experience in community collaboration through my voluntary involvement with numerous nonprofits, boards, commissions, all serving Riverside families. This experience has given me opportunities to team with people from different cultures, different backgrounds, income levels, and perspectives in a collaborative process. Everyone had a seat at the table, and together we worked to find common ground and come up with solutions for the greater good. And although we may not have agreed on many items, we were able to discuss issues at hand in a civil manner without raising voices and without name calling. Collaboration and communication are the keys to success. Communication is crucial to the success of the mayor's office. Interpreting the actions taken by council and communicating those to the people and then taking the will of the people and communicating back to council. That's the mayor's role according to our city charter. So let's do just that and make the communication collegial with give and take on both sides, encouraging creative thinking and diversity of opinions. The mayor's office should be open, inviting, and transparent to all, a true reflection of our inclusive and diverse community. All residents should be heard, respected, and appreciated. We need real change, real communication, and real involvement. I offer you that change, that choice, and humbly ask for your vote to become the next mayor of Riverside.
Thank you. Rusty.
As you can tell, I love Riverside. We have incredible momentum now since the public investment in the Riverside Renaissance. And that is what you told us recently in Seizing Our Destiny Quality of Life Survey. A survey we take every 2 years to gather feedback on what we are doing well, what we need to improve on as a leadership team. Survey says, and data reflects that crime is up in our city, which is why we need to continue to invest in public safety and to support our professional police force and exemplary firefighters. The survey also told us that we need to further focus our efforts on addressing homelessness. Just like we did last year, we came together around the table with the appropriate stakeholders to house 89 homeless vets in our city. Thank you to all those who stepped up and stepped in to fight as we end up. The survey also showed us what we are doing well as a city. Over the past 4 years, Riverside has experienced great success. The survey indicates that our residents believe that good jobs are easy to find, up from 52 to 62%. Riverside believes that our air and water quality is improving, and that Riverside is a place where they can realize their goals. 84% of those surveyed believe that Riverside is a good place for business, and here are the facts. More than 100 small businesses are opening every month. More than $20 million are invested on average each month through the development process and the title process in City Hall. We are streamlining and modernizing those efforts to be more efficient and effective, cutting red tape. So what I've done for 4 years as your mayor, I want to continue the momentum of Riverside. So I'm committed to continuing the growth of our economy across the entire city. I'm committed to focus on increasing the number and quality of jobs for Riverside. I'm committed to continue to improve public safety and neighborhood livability, protecting you and your property. I'm committed to continue to end homelessness amongst veterans and applying. applying those lessons learned across the population, and committed to the long-term prosperous future of our city, my hometown, your Riverside. So I ask you to leave Riverside and continue the momentum. And I only ask for your vote for reelection to be your mayor, a mayor for Riverside. God bless you all, and God bless you.
Always interested in being on the highest board in almost 8 years, and what we hear and see, but learn something new every day. Well, as a longtime council representing Ward 4 and as a mayor candidate, I can stand for and tell you I represent the people protecting your interests locally in a full and transparent manner, as my record stands beside anyone else's. I represent the people's voice, not the voice of the old guard of Riverside. We need accountability from the highest level of government, and will fight for any intrusion to your rights as citizens in the business of our community, certainly our country. I stand for true leadership through selfless acts of representation, not for personal gain or self-interest. I'm running for the office to restore the integrity of the city, our local government, to bring reasonable objective views back to our city residents and businesses, providing opportunity for all while eliminating the bureaucracy and necessary regulation unfairly imposed by the bureaucrats of our city. We will build upon the foundation that has been laid before us by current past city councils while building lasting relationships locally and internationally, facilitating the creation of sustainable jobs in all sectors of employment, where even those who have not had a college degree can be valuable vocational low and low cost of job training, so that they can also live and thrive in the city of Riverside, our community. I'll respect the institution of our charter and the city council while restoring proven leadership, professionalism, and earn respect back to the office of the mayor and our great city. My vision for Riverside is to deliver the best possible results for our community we serve by embracing and living a shared set of core values that the entire council has adopted, including the office of mayor. Riverside is my home, and it is yours as well. I want to be for our children and for our families. As mayor, I will lead by example, provide leadership, create expertise, and collaboration, and communication, as well as inclusiveness, while giving credit where credit is due and not stealing valor from others. Support the council to advance the city's strategic plan and uphold the charter. I will get things done by actions rather than empty words and promises. Under my leadership, we will facilitate local vocational job training. I can stress that because it is critical to our success. I stand for our future, not relishing in the past. Join me and we'll focus on changing our future for Riverside's sake.
Thank you. That concludes this evening's forum. Can we please have a round of applause for our candidates?